Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain.
Hello, a very good day to you. My name is Sister Temi Tayo, and I'm here once again to share the Open Heavens daily devotional compiled by the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Pastor E.A. Adeboye. And the reason I'm sharing from this particular Christian book is because the Lord instructed me to do so as I prepare to enter into the year 2020. So this is my fourth year of sharing from the Open Heavens. And all those videos from 2020 are all loaded on my YouTube channel. My handle on YouTube is Temi Agedo, which is right on the screen. I'll encourage you to visit my channel, not only to view those old Open Heavens videos, which are a great study guide, but most importantly, to view the Open Heavens for the current day. And I know you'll be blessed as you listen. Pastor Adeboye led me to Christ in October 1997, a few years back when I was in the University of Lagos, Nigeria, in West Africa. And Pastor gives you a few scriptures from the Bible and a memory verse, and that helps you to understand the body of the text and what the Spirit of God is saying to the person who's reading the daily devotional on that particular day. So praise God. Today is Saturday, July the 15th. Praise God. Saturday, July the 15th, which happens to be my birthday. And I thank God for giving me the grace to see another year. Saturday, July the 15th. And we're continuing on our series, The Role of the Holy Spirit. So yesterday we started The Role of the Holy Spirit part one. It's a three-day series, and we're going to be looking at part two today. And I pray that God will help us in Jesus' name, because everything that relates to the Holy Spirit is very important and every Christian must pay attention. Praise God. So we're going to be looking at The Role of the Holy Spirit part two. And we're going to be looking at Romans chapter 8, verses 26 to 27. Romans chapter 8, verses 26 to 27. And I'm going to be reading from the traditional King James Version, because these verses are much better in the King James. I will encourage you to read other modern translations, but for the purpose of this study, we're going to be looking at the King James Version. And thus goes the reading of God's Word, Romans chapter 8, verses 26 to 27. Likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities, for we know not what we should pray for as we ought. But the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. And he that searcheth the heart knoweth what is the mind of the Spirit, because he maketh intercession for the saints according to the will of God. Let me take that a bit slower. Likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities, for we know not what we should pray for as we ought. But the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. And he that searcheth the heart knoweth what is the mind of the Spirit, because he maketh intercession for the saints according to the will of God. May the Holy Spirit bless the reading of God's word. Now, our memory verse is taken from those two verses. It's taken from Romans 8:27, and it says, and he that searcheth the heart knoweth what is the mind of the Spirit, because he maketh intercession for the saints according to the will of God. Now, as I'm just sharing this, what does that mean? It means that, you see, there are two spirits. There's the Holy Spirit, which we see with capital S in the scriptures. And then there's the human spirit, which is our own spirit, okay, with the small letter S. This is the easiest way to describe it. And before a man is born again, his spirit is dead because of sin. So the Holy Spirit cannot connect to that person's spirit, because spirit is dead because of sin. But once a person becomes born again, his spirit becomes alive to God, and God can speak to that person's human spirit. For example, I'm born again, so the Holy Spirit will speak to my spirit and give me direction. And that's why the Bible says that the spirit of a man is the candle of the Lord, by which he searcheth the inward parts of the heart. So let's break this verse down. Likewise, the Spirit, with capital S, is talking about God, the Holy Spirit, also helpeth our infirmities. When he says infirmities, what does it mean? It means that God also helps us in our weaknesses. We have weaknesses as human beings because we are flesh and blood, you know, so we have some weaknesses. But then the Bible is telling us that the Holy Spirit helps us in our weaknesses. You know, he helps us in our weaknesses. He bears us up in our weaknesses. He says, we don't know what we should pray for as we ought. He says, but the Spirit itself. Now, this is, you don't know how to pray for us, what we should pray for as we ought. In other words, you may be praying, or be praying concerning a particular situation. But that's not actually the issue. You see, because God knows all things. So we don't know what to pray for as we ought. You know, we are praying for a school for your daughter. You are praying, "Oh God, I want this school, I want this school." But that's not actually the issue that God wants you to pray about. You understand? He wants, there's something deeper than what you think. So we don't know what we should pray for as we ought. And this is why we pray in the spirit. Say, because the spirit itself, King James uses the word itself, which is very wrong, you know, because the Holy Spirit is not a thing. He's a person. He's a person. He has emotions and he can be great. He's a person. The spirit himself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. This way, why we pray in the Holy Ghost. And as you're praying in the spirit, you pray, you pray, you pray. The Spirit of God is making it together. The Bible says he's, "I'll send you another comforter, counselor, helper, intercessor. He maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered." That's he's praying together with us against our weaknesses. You know, so when you're praying in the Holy Ghost, you're praying and you're praying and you're praying and you're from out of your belly, something is going on. There's an eruption. You are praying, Malikataya. And you know, you're holding your belly. You are praying. He's praying. He maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. Don't be like, "Ah, this brother is too spiritual, spiritual." No, something is going on inside his spirit, inside her spirit, inside my spirit, the spirit himself. So you're praying, your tongues are changing from the regular rah, 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 mama, okay. It's going deeper, and you are speaking new syllables, and there's fire starting in your belly. The spirit himself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. You get to a stage where you are trying to utter the words, and you are gosh, okay, yeah, ha. You are from deep inside, you're groaning. The spirit of God is making intercession for you. Continue. Don't stop. Keep press. Keep pressing. Keep pressing till the Holy Spirit takes you to a higher level. Now, in that verse 27, which is our memory verse, it says that he that searcheth the heart, he knoweth what is the mind of the spirit, because he maketh intercession for the saints according to the will of God. He searcheth, he knows the intents of the heart. Okay, so when you're praying concerning maybe your sister, you're praying concerning one particular brother, the brother looks very nice, but something is wrong. So you can't put your finger on it. Be praying in the Holy Ghost. The Spirit of God reveal that which is hidden. Or you're praying concerning the sister, the Spirit of God reveal that which is hidden. Amen. Praise the Lord. So the role of the Holy Spirit. Now, the gift of praying in tongues. Some people say, "Oh, I don't have the gift of praying in tongues." That's not true. You know, this is a free gift. It's like the gift of salvation, the gift of speaking in other tongues. Yeah, Jesus Christ said, "This sign shall follow," Mark chapter 16. He said, "This sign shall follow them that believe in my name. They shall cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues." So that new tongues, which is the tongue, our spiritual heavenly language that we speak in tongues, eh? It's only the Holy Spirit that can give it. It's part of the package of salvation. Now I sell cosmetics, and when somebody's when I started the business, they gave me what we call a starter kit. They gave me a starter kit. So that's what I used to start my business. Okay. In our salvation, starter kit is the gift of new tongues. Amen. It's inside your starter kit. The same way you asked for salvation and received salvation into your life and you became born again, is the same way you will ask to be filled with the Holy Spirit, with the evidence of speaking in tongues. You lambano it. You take it by force. It's yours. God has given it to you already. This is different from the gift of diverse tongues. Okay, don't say, "Oh, God didn't give me the gift." God has given everybody this gift of tongues. It's in your starter kit, your salvation pack. Okay, so take, you need it. Huh? You can make heavens without speaking in tongues, but you lose a lot along the way. Praise God. So take it by force. The way you took your salvation is the same way you take this gift of speaking in tongues, and keep praying without ceasing. Amen. In the Holy Ghost, pray and pray and pray. Hallelujah. The Bible says we must build up ourselves on our most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost. Let's go straight into the daily devotional. Now, Pastor says we started to look at the role of the Holy Spirit in the life of a Christian yesterday, and we discovered that the Holy Spirit convicts sinners of their sin and draws them onto repentance. Today, we want to look at how the Holy Spirit helps believers pray. So yesterday, we're talking about how the Holy Spirit, he convicts of sin. You understand? So like when we go out to preach to, you know, to people, talk to people about our Lord Jesus Christ, even if it's just you and that person, it's not just you and that person, because the Holy Spirit is walking with you. Jesus Christ said, the Spirit of God will walk with us, confirming his word with signs following. You know, and the Bible said the Lord walked with them, confirming their words with signs following. So as I'm preaching the gospel to somebody, like now we are sharing the word of God. As I'm talking, you are seeing me. The Holy Spirit is working on your heart. He convicts men of sin. Amen. Maybe God has called you into a similar calling and you've been running away and you see somebody, you know, doing what you should be doing also. The Spirit of God is convicting your heart that I sent you to do that also. And when he convicts us, we must yield. But Pastor is saying that today we're going to be looking at how the Holy Spirit helps believers to pray. He helpeth our weaknesses. So there are times we want to pray and you are so tired. Maybe in the middle of the night, the Holy Ghost wakes you up and you are struggling. You are struggling because you are tired. The Spirit, as you continue, he will pick you up. He will pick you up. You will just realize that, you were tired. 30 minutes, 1 hour. He will pick you in that your weakness, that your tiredness, in our tiredness, he will pick you up and you begin to pray. Where did the strength come from? The Holy Spirit. At that point where you are able to, if you are willing to continue, he will pick you up. He helpeth our infirmities when we know not what we should pray as we ought. Amen. So he's our helper in our weaknesses. His strength is made perfect. So when you want to pray, just start and be willing to continue. The Holy Spirit would, it will just pick you up and take you on the fast lane. When the Bible says that we should pray without ceasing in 1 Thessalonians 5:17, how can this be possible? Humanly speaking, clearly this can only be possible with the help of the Holy Spirit. And this is why I pity those who deny the baptism of the Holy Spirit as promised by the Lord Jesus Christ, by our Lord Jesus Christ in Acts 1:8. You know, Jesus, our Lord said in Acts 1:8, this was just before he ascended, he said, you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and ye shall be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in Judea, in Samaria, even unto the uttermost parts of the earth. So, you know, the word said we should pray without ceasing. How is that? How do we pray without ceasing? You know, it's only by the power of the Holy Spirit. And that's why wherever we find ourselves, we attend our prayer meetings, we give ourselves continually to prayer and to the ministry of the God's word, and fastings often is the Holy Spirit that helps us, you know, to pray. That's why the Holy Spirit also told us not to forsake the gathering together of the saints, because my house shall be called the house of prayer. Amen. And when we step into the house of God and the prayers are going on, the spirit of prayer is there and we're going to pray. How do we do that? Not by power, and definitely not by might, but by the power of God's Holy Spirit that raised our Lord Jesus Christ from the dead. Our Lord Jesus Christ gave a parable to teach us important ceaseless prayer. Gave a parable to teach us how important ceaseless prayer is to us as believers in Luke 18 verses 1 to 8. However, without the help of the Holy Spirit, no one can accomplish this. You can't pray without ceasing, without the Holy Spirit. And you have the Holy, if you are born again, you have the Holy Spirit. It's our down payment, it's the gift, the guarantee that we'll make it to heaven. That's when we became born again. God gave us the gift of the Holy Spirit. Just gave us the gift of the Holy Spirit. You know, so we're baptized into the body of Christ by God, the Holy Spirit. But then you can also be filled with the Spirit. You understand? Filled with the Spirit that you're already inside. To be filled with all the fullness of God. When you're filled with the Spirit, you open your mouth and it comes out in tongues. Naturally, we do not even know what to pray for, but the Holy Spirit guides us and prays the will of God through us. In Romans 8:26, it says, likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities. For we know not what we should pray for as we ought, but the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. So we don't know what we should pray for. So you sit down, you have your prayer point, and you're praying. It's always wise to have pen and paper with you when you're praying, because God will talk. He may not talk when he knows you don't have pen and paper. Mm-hmm. Because you see, when the Holy Spirit talks, you may forget. So, and that's why it's important. God, you may be praying about something and all of a sudden you remember, you need to submit a form. Don't stop the prayer to go and attend to the form. You just remember that, you're expecting visitors tomorrow. You need to get something done. You're just praying. The Holy Spirit brought to your remembrance. That's the Holy Spirit. You know, don't stop your prayer to go and attend to that thing. Just write it down and continue your prayer. The devil is the one that wants to draw you away from that prayer. He knows that God has brought something to your heart. Write it down and continue your prayer. I remember one time I was praying in church and the Holy Spirit said to me, call Auntie Gloria. We were just praying about it, and I hadn't seen Auntie Gloria for a long time. So So I thought, okay, call her later. No, I didn't. I just forgot, but I continued my prayer. And lo and behold, after service, I get a ring for Auntie Gloria that I've not spoken to in a long time. And she said, and I was like, oh my God, that's Auntie Gloria. And the Holy Spirit reminded me to call you today. She was like, yeah, right, yeah. But you didn't. So the Spirit, and don't take those little promptings, act on them. The more you act on the promptings of the Holy Spirit, the more He speaks. Praise God. From the scripture above, we see that we need the Holy Spirit to help us pray the right way. Then we need to pray more. The Holy Spirit also reminds us the significance of, so, the Holy Spirit, He knows the issue. You are thinking you want to pray this way, but the Holy Spirit is not, that is not the issue at hand. You understand? That's not the issue at hand. You are praying concerning your mother-in-law. That she's not the issue. It's deeper than that. There's something going on that the Spirit of God will reveal to you. Okay? It's something deeper. The Spirit of God will reveal to you. The Holy Spirit also reminds us of the significance of giving thanks as we pray. Indeed, our thanksgiving, praise, and worship should always exceed our requests. In Philippians 4:6, it says, "Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God." So you see, the Spirit of God reminds us that we should give thanks for where we are on the way to where we're going. You are angry that, oh God, I've been praying about this for years and I've not seen the results. But then there are some things God is reminding you, remembering the thing that God has done. He makes you see some things and you're like, God, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. For example, recently I had a very sharp knife and I mistakenly cut my hand. I cut my hand, it was very deep, was bleeding all over the place. I was praying while I was praying before I cut my hand, And when it got caught, in every situation, there's much to thank God for. First of all, I thank God that it was not my right hand because I was right-handed. Secondly, I thank God because even after I cut my hand and it was bleeding, the blood clotted in time, and I was seeing with my very eyes the wound closing up because the Holy Spirit was doing something. Yes, I had to get it, go to the hospital and get it stitched up, but it didn't hinder me from doing all the things I was, even though it was a very deep cut. I know the doctors were saying, oh, if you can't drive, just get somebody to bring you. I was like, I'll come myself. It was deep, but there was still a reason to thank God because it could have been worse. The plan of Satan was worse than what happened. Praise God. So there's always something to give thanks for. In that bad situation, there's always a room for thanksgiving. Amen. There's always room for thanksgiving. Hallelujah. And that's what the Holy Spirit does. He lets you see the what God has done, that you may not be looking at this way, but God has actually done something even greater. This indeed. So, for example, maybe you apply to go to a country now and they deny your visa. You don't know why. You're angry that God denied, that the visa was denied, and you had prayed and you had fasted. You don't know. Give thanks in all situations, in everything. Give thanks because this is the will of God in Christ Jesus. These are indeed keys to get our prayers answered. Hence, all Christians must seek to be baptized in the Holy Ghost. Don't listen to those people who deny the baptism of the Holy Spirit. They are being moved by Satan. Jesus Christ said to us, our Lord said that we should receive the, he said to his disciples, I cannot guarantee, you've been with me 3.5 years, but I cannot guarantee your success. So wait in Jerusalem. Make sure you wait in Jerusalem until you receive the Holy Spirit. Don't go anywhere. Don't do anything. Just wait and keep praying. So don't let anybody deceive you that you don't need the Holy Spirit. That is not from God. Now the prayer point is, Holy Spirit divine, please come into my life and help me in my prayer life. Holy Spirit divine, come into my life and help me in my prayer life. Let us pray. Dear Holy Spirit, we thank you. Power of the highest, we worship you. We thank you because you are the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. We thank you, Almighty God, because you are the one who raised our Lord Jesus Christ from the dead. You are the power of the Most High that overshadowed Mary and caused her to bring forth as a virgin. Father, we thank you because Holy Spirit, you are our comforter, our counselor, our helper, our intercessor, our advocate, our strengthener, and our standby. Thank you because you are the one that helps our infirmities. We ask even now, Lord Jesus Christ, that you will baptize every one of us with your Holy Spirit and with your fire. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the Bible says that your fire fell from heaven upon the apostles and they speak with new tongues. Father, even now, because you are the same yesterday, today, and forever, pour out your Holy Spirit upon every one of us who are watching this video, who are listening, in the name of Jesus. And let your fire burn up every shaft with unquenchable fire, in the name of Jesus Christ. Help us to pray always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, in the name of Jesus Christ. We receive that fire in Jesus' name. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Thank you, dear Lord Jesus, for your Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen and amen. Thank you so much for taking time to listen to me. I hope this blessed you, and I hope the video is not too long. God bless you. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Don't forget to watch yesterday's video so you can have a wholesome picture, understanding of what God is saying.
Come on!